Welcome back to the Mass Effect Andromeda gameplay series. In our first installments, we took a closer look at combat gameplay. Today, we're diving straight into the heart of Mass Effect Andromeda, exploration. In addition to beautiful story missions, Andromeda is filled with worlds to explore.
No way this is home.
Our story is contained within the Helios Cluster, a portion of space populated with dozens of star systems. And the Tempest is where that exploration begins. You can navigate star systems using the Tempest galaxy map. From planets to moons, to anomalies and starships, wherever you are in Helios, you'll now be able to see everything that exists outside the ship's main windows in real time. In Andromeda, there are over 100 planets to discover, and a handful of beautifully crafted worlds can be landed on. And that's where the adventure really begins. Each world you visit has its own story, its own characters, and of course, its own challenges. Today, the world we're going to visit is called Elladan. Exploring the opening landing area, called Paradise, you'll quickly discover that the heat on this planet can be deadly. Water is scarce, and mysterious ancient artifacts dot the landscape guarded by dangerous remnant creatures. Basically, to live here, you have to be desperate. Or Krogan. But even the Krogan aren't happy, and they don't trust anyone from the Initiative, least of all a Pathfinder. How you deal with the Krogan and these challenges will ultimately determine your success on Elladan.
We need the Krogan, and the Krogan need us.
Before you set out, you'll get an update from your AI, pointing out key locations.
The Remnant Monolith suggests this was indeed supposed to be a golden world.
We're going to start the adventure by heading over to the Krogan colony, but the choice of where to go is ultimately yours. Our all-terrain rover, the Nomad, is key to quickly covering the expansive landscapes throughout Andromeda. You can also enhance the Nomad with a series of functional upgrades designed to give you better turbo boost, higher jumps, better handling, and more. While you're exploring, one of the key objectives will be to discover locations to call down forward stations. Once found, each of these will act as a fast travel point and allow you to change your loadout or call the Nomad if it gets lost or destroyed. They also offer resupply and protection from any environmental hazards. Our conversations at the Krogan colony point us in a few directions. Exiles are causing trouble at their base, the Flophouse, and a derelict remnant ship may have a drive core the Krogan are in desperate need of. Let's head to that ship and see what we can find. Out here, we are more exposed to the heat. In Andromeda, all of the planets have localized and/or global hazards. The Pathfinder and the Nomad are both separately outfitted with life support systems that help protect against these hazards. But once you run out, you'll need to find a safe location or a forward station to recharge.
I'm reading a normal temperature range, Pathfinder.
As you travel throughout the world, you'll find new areas to explore, new characters, and new storylines. Ultimately, all of these discoveries will help raise the viability of the planet. Increasing planet viability does two things. Allow for the creation of an outpost, and upgrade the Nexus, the Andromeda Initiative space station. Before a planet can support an outpost, you'll first need to get its viability to at least 40% by pacifying threats, allying yourself with the locals, solving environmental problems, and accomplishing specific tasks related to that planet's story. For example, in the case of Elladan, your relationship with the Krogan will determine whether you can build here or not. Regardless of whether you build an outpost, your exploration and discoveries will also give you Andromeda viability points. Reaching thresholds will allow you to upgrade the Nexus and wake up more colonists from cryosleep. Who you decide to wake up will determine what perks and advantages you'll get. Will you wake up scientists to give you an edge in research and development? Military personnel to give you an edge in combat? Or merchants to give you a leg up when trading? But of course, not everything on these worlds will be so straightforward. Andromeda holds many mysteries, not the least of which is a vast network of ancient vaults. Simply figuring out how to access one of these vaults is a challenge in and of itself that can take you across an entire world. Once inside, you'll need to rely on skills from every element of Andromeda gameplay, including exploration, environmental navigation, puzzle solving, and combat to get them back online, and then make it out alive. Go! And resolving the mystery of these vaults may just hold the key to survival in Andromeda.
This is unbelievable.
At its heart, Mass Effect Andromeda is a game of discovery and exploration. The choices you make and the places you go let you blaze your own unique trail through Andromeda. Whether you're exploring the depths of a crashed starship or delving into the core of an active volcano, the more you engage with the world around you and the characters in it, the more that world will surprise you with what's waiting just around the corner.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
Explorers first, but it's a new galaxy. We need to be ready for any situation, including combat. I'm Liam Costa, Security and Response Specialist for the Pathfinder team. Before we set out, you need some basic firearms and mobility training. The name of the game is adaptability. Only so much cargo space on the arcs, so initiative weapons and armor designed to be customized multiple times in the field. There's four main types of guns to work with: pistols, shotguns, assault rifles, and sniper rifles. Pistols are your standard medium to short range weapon. Easy to aim and fire, and low recoil so you can shoot on the move. Lightweight, quick to reload. When you're ready to punch it up a little, Carnifex pistol with grenade launcher augmentation for the advanced user. Next, shotguns. Perfect for getting in close. Shotguns are simple. For large targets, grouping, or just some extra kick. They hit hard with a wide shot pattern. Like all our kits, they're highly adaptable. A personal favorite, katana with laser shells. For obvious reasons. Next up, assault rifles. High rate of fire for covering fast targets and making short work of shields. And if you watch your recoil, good at distance too. If you can see your mark, chances are you can hit it. Augmentation of choice, Avenger with electrical conduit. Last in the queue, sniper rifles. The heavy hitters. High powered, accurate, and long, long range. They'll take down almost anything while it's still a speck in your scope. Now, guns aren't everything. Close quarters training is a must. Do you have the finesse for an Asari biotic sword? Or the muscle for a Krogan hammer? Some of you have biotic implants or advanced omni-tool tech. Biotic abilities can shape the world. And if fighting is unavoidable, they'll be your go-to. Any object can be a projectile, even your target. Or just toss them into the air and give squad mates an easy shot. When you're manipulating combat at a gravitational level, almost anything is possible. Omni-tools are tools, and they're just as useful for defense and offense. With tuning and training, they can be outfitted to freeze, burn, or electrify. And never underestimate a tried and true Omniblade. Options are key. I prefer a little of everything, but if you focus on certain skills, you can do amazing things. Biotic Specialist, Adept is the pass for you. Feeling tactical, Sentinel is the way. Want to get in fast and shake things up? Vanguard. Have a look at each specialization and you'll get an idea of what they can do, what you can do. Last but not least, let's talk mobility. Fun mobility. Jump jets. Need the high ground? You've always got it handy. A quick dash will get you out of an attack path. Like everything else, jump jets are adaptable if things get rough. Nothing better for exploration. The initiative is about a new beginning, pioneering. With the right gear and the right skills, we'll be ready for anything. Everyone has a role. And most importantly, we've got each other's backs.
Welcome back to the Mass Effect Andromeda gameplay series. In this video, we will take a look at profiles, favorites, and your squad. As you level up in Mass Effect Andromeda, you'll gain access to dozens of skills and over 300 skill upgrades. You're free to pick any skill without being limited to a class, which allows you to create a Pathfinder that is totally suited to how you want to play. As we discovered last time, there are three main types of skills in the game: combat, tech, and biotics. As you unlock skills over the course of the game, you'll also start gaining access to profiles. There are seven types. Let's take a look at two of them: the Adept and the Explorer. The Adept profile is perfect for players who want to specialize in biotics. As you choose more biotic skills, the Adept profile will give you bonuses to suit your playstyle. And as you can see, choosing Adept gives bonuses to duration and damage of your biotics. The more you invest in those skills, the higher level profiles you can unlock. Or maybe you want to be more versatile, choosing some combat mixed with biotic and tech skills. This will unlock the Explorer profile, giving you perks and buffs that enhance all your abilities. And of course, you can swap these profiles at any time, allowing you to keep the action fresh, giving you a number of ways to tackle every battle, and making sure you never feel locked into a particular style of play. This brings us to favorites. Favorites are a quick way to map three skills and a single profile to one slot. Anytime during combat, you can switch between one of these four slots, giving you access to up to 12 of your favorite skills during the course of a single fight. Here's an example. In this battle, I've equipped a favorites loadout designed for long-range combat, utilizing cloak and a sniper rifle to suppress oncoming enemies. The sniper alone isn't enough, so I'll deploy an assault turret and toss some grenades before switching to my second favorites loadout. It's designed for close quarters combat. Loading these new abilities puts them in a cooldown by default, so I'll have to make do with my shotgun until they're ready. The Fiend is too powerful and I'm not in any position to take it out immediately, but my new favorites are ready. I'll make my getaway using Biotic Charge and then maneuver around this group of enemies. This favorites loadout is particularly combo friendly, so I'll engage by comboing Cryo Beam and Lance for an explosive result, then clean up with my shotgun. It looks like the Fiend has taken an interest. I'll do what I can from a distance before switching to my third favorites loadout, one that emphasizes ranged biotic abilities such as Backlash and Shockwave, as well as Flamethrower. Let's see if we can find a better vantage point and stall the Fiend's approach. Using Backlash, I can shield myself from oncoming fire and deflect it back at the enemy. This is particularly useful against large crowds of enemies. However, this horde is scattered, so I'll need to regroup. Looks like the Fiend has other plans. I'll stand my ground by using Shockwave and then follow that up with Flamethrower. The Fiend is hurt, but it's going to take more than that to defeat it. Switching to my final favorites loadout, I'll engage the Fiend with soldier-focused abilities. Let's finish it off with Flat Cannon and Trip Mines. And when it comes to combat, don't forget your squad. Each of your six squad mates has three active and two passive skills. In this case, Cora uses her biotics as a support character, and Drac is a bruiser who can soak up lots of damage. Not only can you set your squad up around the battlefield, ordering them to defend locations, attack targets, or rally to your side, but you can also team up with them for devastating power combos. Power combos activate when you or one of your squad mates primes an enemy or groups of enemies, setting them up for the kill. Then you or a squad mate jumps in to detonate and finish the job. And you can always level up your squad mates to make them specifically good at priming or detonating targets. Subscribe to see the next installment in the gameplay series for a look at exploration in Mass Effect Andromeda. Welcome to the Mass Effect Andromeda gameplay series. In Mass Effect Andromeda, you are the Pathfinder, the ultimate adventurer in a vast, unexplored galaxy on a mission to find a new home for humanity.
Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean, summer year-round?
Our first video will take a look at weapons and skills. Andromeda's action is built around fluid, fast-paced, third-person combat. Our combat offers amazing freedom of movement with the use of a jump jet that allows you to jump, evade, and even hover while you're fighting. You'll also notice a new dynamic cover system that allows you to seamlessly use almost anything, including your own vehicle, for cover. All this freedom allows you to approach the battle in a way that suits your gameplay style. Let's take a closer look at our weapons. In Mass Effect Andromeda, there are four categories of guns: pistols, shotguns, and sniper and assault rifles, plus a range of melee weapons for up-close combat. All guns are available to every player. There are no class restrictions. So if you decide you want to try something new, it's as easy as switching your loadout. Guns and gear in Andromeda fall into three technology types based on where the tech comes from. Milky Way weapons typically use physical projectile ammunition that's similar to the types of weapons you might be familiar with from our original games, with some advancements, of course. These are high-impact projectile-based guns. They're great against most non-shielded targets, but require you to keep an eye on your ammo. Remnant weapons typically use beams, have a high rate of fire, and are extremely accurate. They use the overheat system and don't rely on ammo, so you'll never run out of ammo, but you'll have to wait for your gun to cool down from time to time. Helios weapons are technology from civilizations that live in the Helios cluster of Andromeda. They are generally plasma-based, which means they are slower speed, but benefit from heat-seeking technology. While some are charge-based, the longer you charge them before releasing, the harder they hit. Melee weapons vary in both damage and speed. Hard-hitting hammers do maximum damage. while lightning-fast shivs or swords allow you to get in and out of harm's way with maximum speed and precision. In addition to weapons, you can also develop skills and abilities. Like the weapons, there are no restrictions on what skills you can choose, and each of the three main categories is designed to facilitate a certain style of play. Combat skills are great if you want to focus on weapons, gear, and making your character the ultimate soldier. These skills focus on improving weapon damage and accuracy, as well as giving you the ability to use flat cannons, grenades, trip mines, and more. Tech skills allow you to equip your Pathfinder with more experimental weaponry, or focus on strategic improvements for you and your squad. Cryo Beam and Flamethrower give you more offensive punch, while skills like Invasion or Energy Drain weaken your opponents and make them easier to take down. Want a little extra help? Deploy your own assault turret. Last but not least, Biotics. By controlling dark energy, your Pathfinder can harness the power of mass and gravity. Biotic skills like Pull and Throw allow you to literally control the battlefield, using your enemies as a shield or even a weapon. Abilities like Annihilation Shield or Singularity can disrupt and damage anything or anyone caught up in their powerful grip. Each skill can be upgraded to become increasingly more devastating and effective. Each also has choices to make when upgrading, offering you more ways to customize your playstyle. Now that we have the basics down, let's put this into action. In this case, our Pathfinder is equipped with a sniper rifle and a shotgun, and they've got their three powers selected. You'll notice that different enemies each behave in unique ways. Some will keep their distance and try to snipe us. Others will charge right in and try to flush us out of cover. Sticky Grenades is an advanced version of the Omni Grenade combat skill. They're effective against just about anything, but they have a limited supply. Enemies each have different strengths and weaknesses. For most, headshots inflict maximum damage, but you'll need to pay attention to their health bars. Yellow means they've got armor and won't be as susceptible to certain weapons and powers. Blue means they're shielded, and in addition to being more resistant to biotics, you'll generally need to deal with those shields before their health goes down. And just like you, their shields will recharge if you don't finish them off quickly. Tactical Cloak is a tech skill that allows you to evade enemy detection and inflict increased damage when attacking from cloak. And finally, Overload, another tech skill that's great for taking out enemy shields and synthetic enemies. By holding it before releasing, you can even chain it to multiple enemies. And this is just one of the hundreds of combinations of weapons and skills you can try in Andromeda. Stay tuned for future installments where we'll show you our profiles to give you an added boost in combat, favorites which allow you immediate access to your sets of powers so you can change up on the fly, and squad skills and commands.
Take cover! Take cover!
Okay.
Okay, hello.
Hello.
Hey. Natalie Dormer plays Lexi Tapero, who is the doctor on board the Tempest.
She's an Asari. Scott Ryder.
The Pathfinder wants you all on your feet right away.
And she's got some experience and wisdom under her belt. And in that way, she's able to advise the player. She isn't without emotion or compassion. So she sort of tries to walk the line of just the professional doctor, but sometimes she tips over it.
It's a seizure. Her brain can't handle the connection.
She's got some great wry lines, some dry humor in there.
It just
means you're still shaking off your nap.
Sorry, that's the last book in the series. The author died before it was finished.
It's so huge, and the production value on this series is just extraordinary. Every single discipline within the project is at its top level, from the design to hopefully the acting involved to just every single level of production. It's people at the top of their game. I had a bit of a moment earlier when Gethin Anthony's voice came in over across my cans. He's doing the voice of Gil in Andromeda. It's kind of a weird one hearing Renly Baratheon and Marjorie Tyrell in different guises.
Ta-da!
Welcome to the Andromeda Initiative. 6 recruits have been selected to navigate the unexplored reaches of the Andromeda Galaxy. Before they take off, they will have to find out what it means to be Pathfinders. To be weightless and fearless. One team of pioneers, skilled astronauts, and bold explorers. 3 days of challenging training at the European Astronaut Center. 2 squads and 1 goal. Become the Pathfinder.
Provided a map, there are no guarantees on a voyage that will take us 2.5 million light years away from home. That's where the Pathfinder team comes in. My name is Cora Harper, second in command on the Human Pathfinder team. It's our job to find and secure potential golden worlds, identify settlement sites, and start the process of building our new home. We act under our own authority and represent the tip of the spear in Andromeda. Every Ark has its own team, and every team has its own Pathfinder. Senior mission officers, experts in survival, diplomacy, and if that fails, combat. Our Pathfinder on Ark Hyperion is Alec Ryder, whose pioneering service history speaks for itself. A skilled soldier with N7 ranking and a talented scientist, Ryder was a member of the original task force who traveled through the Charon Mass Relay and took humanity's first steps across the galaxy. Now, he's preparing us to tackle the next great frontier, Andromeda. Liam specializes in crisis response. Every team needs its idealist, and Liam is ours. Sarah and Scott Ryder are Pathfinder's son and daughter and former Alliance recruits fresh off tours with the Arcturus Station Outpost and Prothean Artifacts team, respectively. And myself, Lieutenant Cora Harper. To be brief, I'm a biotic, the team's operations specialist in charge of ground missions, and I spent the last 4 years serving alongside Asari Commandos. And finally, our last team member, Sam. Short for Simulated Adaptive Matrix, Sam is an artificial intelligence designed by our Pathfinder himself. From his node in the Ark, Sam receives a direct feed of the Pathfinder's sensory input via a neural implant. It sees and feels as Ryder does, providing him advanced situational awareness, problem solving, and even tactical enhancements. All members of the Pathfinder team receive implants, allowing them to communicate directly with Sam. The individuals who make up this team are everything the Andromeda Initiative represents. A chance for the bravest and the brightest to come together for something bigger than ourselves. If you have what it takes to join us, we'll make sure there's a bunk on the Tempest with your name on it.
Is that our golden world?
That's Habitat 7. New Earth, if we're lucky. We're marooned. 20,000 souls adrift at sea. When the power runs out, stays out, we need to know if that's safe harbor.
Shuttle 2, take your lead.
Good luck, Pathfinder team.
All stop, now!
Get us out of here.
They've got us pinned against the scourge.
I am Arkham. Surrender or burn.
Please, you're not really going out there on your own.
We're explorers. Not an army. Sure, we've been outplayed. The Archon is a master of his game. We're about to change the rules.
a human from another galaxy. A pathfinder.
I don't need an army. I've got a Krogan.
Go right, it'll be fun.
This is exactly why we came.
Cover's blown, run!
They want to fight? We'll give it to them!
We're breaking! Keep it up!
Been waiting 600 years for this.
Sam, relay to the Tempest that we're stranded but alive. No choice but to investigate PB's signal.
Pathfinder, this console controls the gate.
Mass Effect Andromeda is the next generation of action RPG.
Yeah, no way this is home.
Brand new epic sci-fi adventure set in a vast explorable galaxy. You are the Pathfinder, part explorer, part soldier, part guide. And it's your mission to find a new home for humanity. But in Andromeda, resources are scarce, worlds are hazardous or outright uninhabitable. Every planet has its own story. On this one, warring outlaw factions fight over every available scrap. You can make new allies or enemies. The choice is yours.
Not too shabby for folk who got kicked off the station with nothing to show for it.
All I see is the trail of bodies they left behind. Sam, tell me about Sloane Kelly.
Before joining the Initiative as head of Nexus Security, Miss Kelly served in the Alliance with a nearly spotless record.
Nearly?
She was involved in multiple altercations with other officers.
A hothead. Great. What brings a Pathfinder to our humble port?
Ven Terev. Name ring any bells?
What's he to you? And don't lie to me.
Just point me to where you're holding him and there won't be any trouble.
There won't be.
Drop it! Now!
You first. Get out, or I'll put you down.
These worlds are big, so for the sake of time, we're going to speed up our adventure. There are many paths to follow on this planet, and you'll need everything at your disposal to survive. Whether it's a six-wheel drive Nomad, which protects you from hazards and enemies, or the scanning and analysis tools to help you interpret everything you discover.
Look for anything that might lead us to the killer.
The tracks make it look like an ambush.
Fits the Rokar profile. It's a start.
And Garn blood. Matches your Rokar theory, Reyes.
Keep scanning. We need hard evidence.
In a dangerous alien galaxy desperate for resources, conflict is inevitable. But you'll have access to futuristic weapons, gear, and powers to help you in your fight for a new home. You start out with the ship and the Nomad. Almost everything else you need, you'll have to find, steal, or craft yourself. And that's critical to your survival. These worlds have many dangers, from environmental hazards to hostile wildlife. Galaxy awaits. How far will you go?
Hi everyone, I'm Aaron Flynn, General Manager here at BioWare. I'm excited to show you a glimpse of how Mass Effect Andromeda is taking the power of Frostbite to new heights on the Sony PlayStation Neo platform. Before we get started, if you're not watching this in a 4K screen, find one and come back. Our game is going to look fantastic on whatever platform you choose to play on. But this video was meant to be experienced in 4K. 4K allows the game to take on new levels of depth, making Mass Effect more immersive than ever.
No sunlight, no water. They should all be dead.
What you're seeing here is a very small slice of the game in development. Everything here is in-game, captured directly from a PlayStation Neo during pre-alpha. We selected this segment specifically to showcase some of the ways that Neo will bring our environments and characters to life like never before.
More remnant.
Remember, they don't turn nasty unless you get too close.
Beyond higher resolutions, we will offer high dynamic range lighting on supported platforms. That means every detail will come to life with a sense of depth, richness, and realism that simply hasn't been possible in the past.
Will you look at that?
Wow, I really was just scratching the surface.
Feel that? This whole platform's resonating. Something. Must be close. No question. This is the heart of the vault.
We leave you now with a cutscene where you can really see our characters up close. Be sure to tune in on November 7th when we'll premiere our brand new trailer and officially open the doors to the next chapter of the Mass Effect universe.
Is that the Helios cluster?
Yeah, there we are.
All these points could be vaults in other worlds. Dormant like this one.
Hey, look there. The whole place is lighting up. Power readings are off the chart. Really off the chart.
But if it's back online, we should be good.
Go!
Congratulations on your successful acceptance into the Andromeda Initiative. My name is Gian Garson, the founder of this unprecedented mission. This journey is a major milestone for all of humanity, as well as every other species in the Milky Way galaxy. You are about to embark on a voyage unlike anything attempted before. And make no mistake, this is a one-way trip. 600 years from now, you will awake from cryostasis on the outskirts of the Andromeda Galaxy. Most of you will be aboard Ark Hyperion, while the rest will travel on the Nexus with me. In addition to Hyperion, three other Arks, each harboring a separate species, will depart the Milky Way at the same time. Each Ark will be assigned its own Pathfinder, a blend of elite soldier, scientist, and guide, who will be tasked with finding a new home on one of the golden worlds that our long-range sensors have identified within Andromeda's Helios cluster. Over the coming months, you will be briefed on a selection of classified information, all of which will be critical to your success. Arcs and Nexus overviews, ground and space vehicle certification, outpost establishment guidelines, first contact protocols should we encounter new sapient life forms. In addition, those accepted onto the Pathfinder team will also receive weapons, biotics, and survival training for even the harshest environments. You represent some of the best humanity has to offer, and I again salute your bravery in accepting this mission. There are no guarantees, no certainties. But if successful, we have a chance to do the impossible and create a new future for all humanity. Begin your journey.
We slept for hundreds of years, dreaming of a new home. But when we finally awoke, our dreams of peace were shattered.
Welcome back.
You're the new Pathfinder.
This is incredible.
It's acting like a gravity well.
I have a bad feeling.
We're the aliens.
My God.
This path began a long time ago. A course paved through human history that took us across continents, oceans, and ultimately to the stars. For us, this planet is home. It's protected us, challenged us, and provided us the foundation to become galactic citizens. But the time has come to prepare ourselves for a future beyond the Milky Way. A future that begins 600 years from where we stand, in a time and place among unknown stars and unseen dangers. And so we issue this call to the brave, the inquisitive, to the trailblazers of the human race, as an invitation to stand on the shoulders of those who came before and challenge yourself to go further. Begin your journey. Join the Andromeda Initiative today.
Our survival as a species has always depended on our drive to seek out the undiscovered, push beyond our limits, and expand the boundaries of our known world. With Mass Effect, we are going further than ever before. To Andromeda, to build a new home for humanity. Imagine distant star systems with remote and hostile planets, teeming with alien life and civilizations. Worlds where adventure, danger, and the unknown are waiting to be discovered. We've created a universe that you will lose yourself in. A whole new galaxy for you to explore.
We are travelers.
Clear, Jim. Deploy was on time, and I got the
constantly short. Moving forward. And looking back. Alone and as one. We have no choice but to try. For our insatiable curiosity. For our fear of what should happen if we don't. You are that explorer now. We will say goodbye, and you will look back one last time. And know that wherever you go, we will be with you. This is Commander Shepard, signing off.